Victory is supported by Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.
Greetings and welcome to another exciting program here on BCTV. Be informed, be involved, your community television program. This is the Victory Show. I'm Tom Frank, your Victory host. Thanks for tuning in and hope you stay tuned in. We brought in tonight to the Victory Circle here in Studio A of BCTV. We brought in the Westlawn United Methodist Church. All churches in Berks County and beyond are very special in their own unique way. However, this church is another big year mark of 100 years in existence here in Berks County in Westlawn, right on Woodside Avenue and Penn Avenue. Let's meet our guests who we have tonight. These are the people who are really involved in the scenes behind planning the centennial celebrations for all of 2012. We'll start with Mike.
Thank you, Tom. My name is Mike Reinert. I'm a member of Westlawn United Methodist Church and the chairman of the Centennial Celebration, which has taken place this year in 2012, celebrating 100 years of the church. Looking at our history, we have history displays around the church, some collectibles we're selling, a video Tom and I are working on, and some really special events that we'll be telling you about. Centennial Sunday, May 20th, a banquet on June 9th, and a lot of other things going on. So stick around, we'll update you about it and invite you to be a part of the Westlawn Centennial this year.
Fabulous.
My name is Jeff Raffoff. I grew up at Westlawn Church, and it was my privilege to come back in July of 2000 to be the senior pastor, and I've continued in that role ever since.
Welcome.
Hi, I'm Lucy Regal. It was my grandfather's barn in which the first worship service was held.
And we're going to learn more about that throughout tonight's program. Really interesting work.
I'm Jim Woodring. I've been a member of Westlawn United Methodist Church since 1964, and actually I've been concentrating more on the historical events of the church.
Wonderful.
Hello, I'm Jim's wife, Beverly. We've been working together on the history of the church for this centennial event, and we've been finding out a lot of very neat things about our church over the past 100 years.
Indeed. Now, the Woodrings are part of the Centennial Committee as the historians, and they brought in some really great artifacts that we're going to show you and have a little show and tell. I just want to mention that we wish we could have put all the members, the active members of the Centennial Group, with us here in the studio, but it's quite large, 25-plus members. They are our hidden heroes. They are, some of them are with us in the studio tonight. Many of them are watching us, as you are, right from your conference of your home. And we just want to send out a very strong, powerful thank you to all the members of Westlawn United Methodist Church in making this year extra special. Let's talk about the present day, where, again, we're located at Woodside Avenue and Penn Avenue, right there on the corner, right in Westlawn. And Pastor Jeff, could you tell us about present day Westlawn United Methodist Church?
Well, I think it's an exciting church to be a part of. We actually worship three times every Sunday. We have a very traditional service, looks an awful lot like what I grew up with. We worship at 8 o'clock. We have a wonderful organist playing a magnificent organ that was installed in 1993, so it's relatively new for organs. And then we do that service over again at 11 o'clock. It's almost identical. There are a few little tweaks to it. In the middle there, we have a 9:30 service, which features very contemporary instruments, drums and guitars, a lot of video-based, it's a video-based service. We sing off the screens and we use video clips and such. And that service has actually gone so well that starting April 1st, we're going to be introducing a fourth service on Sunday mornings in our community center right across Noble Street. It's at Woodside and Noble, and in the former Borough Hall at Westlawn, it's now our community center. We'll be worshiping at 11:10 in the same style as the 9:30 service. So we have about 630 people come out to worship on a Sunday morning right now. We're hoping with the new service it'll grow.
Fabulous. We have a current photo to show you kind of what the church and the sanctuary and the education center and the community center all together looks like on graphics. We're going to show you that graphics, and as we do, you can see a beautiful sanctuary which is right on the corner of Woodside and Penn Avenue right there in Westlawn. It's kind of the heart of Westlawn in the center of that beautiful borough that has been there originally since 1912. And we're going to talk more about that. The artifacts we brought in tonight, we're going to show you a Christmas ornament display that is available for sale, and of course a hometown collectible which is here on the news desk here in the studio, and we can show you a tighter camera shot as we discuss those items. Those items are helping to generate some seed money, which is eventually bringing it to a DVD video presentation for all congregation members to be able to purchase. You'll see a sample of that throughout tonight's program. We're going to show for the very first time, so we're very thrilled and happy to show you that. This is LI programming, and if you have any comments or questions that you do want to call in with, we encourage those home viewers to do call the studio. The number you can reach us at here is 610-378-0426, as you see it now on your screen. Mike, can you tell us how the Centennial Committee came about and where it currently is at right now?
I can, Tom. Thank you very much. Planning a 100th birthday party, you have to take some time and you need some helpers. So we're very blessed. We have a committee of about, 25 to 30 volunteers. We actually started working this back in June of 2010. So it's been almost 2 years we've been working on the Centennial for this year, 2012. We wanted to make it really special. We really love the church. We love God. We love serving Him. And we love celebrating His faithfulness in our congregation and all the wonderful things that are happening at West Lawn United Methodist Church and the journey we've taken in the past 100 years. So we got started selling some collectibles, as Tom mentioned, that has been a big help to us. There's some history displays at different places around the church campus where you can see some of the artifacts. You're going to see them during this program. We're also working on a history video. You're going to see a little bit of that. And we're working on some events this year, and maybe you'd like to join us. Our Centennial Sunday is going to be Sunday, May 20th. And all our three services, I guess we have four now, we'll say all our morning services, we're going to have some special centennial observances, including a message from our conference bishop, Peggy Johnson, who's the bishop of our Eastern Pennsylvania Conference. So that'll be very special on May 20th. And then also on Saturday night, June 9th, we're having a banquet. You know, we're Methodists, so we love to eat. It'll be more than a covered dish, though. It'll be a banquet at the Crown Plaza Hotel. And we have a special speaker, a nationally known Christian author and speaker, Dr. Tony Campolo. He's a very lively speaker, a prolific writer, a really interesting guy. He's not too far away. He's there at Eastern University down on the main line, and he's going to be our keynote speaker. And you can get some more information. You can choose a beef, a chicken, or a fish dinner. It's only $30 a person, so we think it's fairly affordable. And we're going to have a wonderful time on Saturday, June 9th, breaking bread and having some fellowship. There's a couple other events, too. We're working on a special concert on Sunday, June 9th by the Essence of Joy Alumni Singers. There's a large group of amazing singers. They're going to have a concert at the church that Sunday afternoon. And Veterans Day this year, November 11th, just happens to be a Sunday, and we're planning a special veterans tribute, too. So we have a lot going on, and if you'd like to know more about it, contact the church and get involved with West Lawn United Methodist Church and our centennial celebration.
Wonderful. Absolutely. We have a home viewer at this time. Let's go to the home viewer. Welcome to Victory on BCTV.
You know, I like the West Lawn UMC because it's a very outgoing church.
Wonderful. Well, thank you for your comments. We really appreciate that support. And yes, a lot of community members in the community do come out, especially on the Wednesday evenings when they have the Feed the Body, Feed the Soul program.
I am a member of there, and I love it.
Fabulous. Then that's part of the reason why West Lawn United Methodist has been so successful, members like you. And we thank you for that.
Yeah, and I also told some friends to come out to the services, too.
Wonderful. Build that membership. Wow, that's the way to do it. Thank you for your support. Also, part of the Bible studies, which are dozens of Bible studies throughout the week, let's mention, if we could, one of many special ones, and this is Serving to Save. Pastor Jeff, tell us about that 2209, as they call it, Serving to Save.
Well, our youth group is what Tom's referring to, and they meet in what used to be the firehouse, literally the firemen's firefighters quarters above with the truck bays. As we took over the community center, or took over the borough hall and converted it to the community center, we established that space above the truck bays, which is now a kitchen. We established it for our youth ministry, and they now call it the Firehouse Cafe. They took as their inspiration Jeremiah 20, verse 9. It refers to having the Word of God within you like a burning flame that you can't contain it. And so our hope is that we can raise up young people who will love the Word of God and want to share it with their friends.
Fabulous. We're going to go at this time to the video segment, specially edited by BCTV and help produced by Mike Reinert, about the 10-minute, 8-minute segment. You're going to really see a quick history lesson. Then we're going to come back to the studio live and see the historical facts that we brought in by the wood rings.
I'm here in the prayer room in the Reiner Education Building, and with me here is Mrs. Betty Reiner, and her husband, Reverend Roland T. Reiner, was the senior pastor here at Westlawn United Methodist Church for 40 years, from 1942 to 1982. And this room is here in his memory, and it's so we're so blessed to have you here to recall some of the history of the church.
We came in spring of 42 during the war. There were about 200, 225 people, members at that time. But most of the fellows were away at war. It was an odd time to start. But we pulled through for a few years until the war was over. And after that, things began to spring and grow. People were moving in. People were getting married and moving here, having children. You know, everything was growing.
I understand that when you and Reverend Reiner came here, there was a sheriff sale sign.
There had been before. I think that March, I guess the church had debts. But between that time and when Raleigh came in May, some of the men of the church and the conference, I understand, got together and pulled them out, so they were all set to go. So we had none of that to worry about.
What was the building like at the time?
It was the rear section to the alley at that time. Prior to that, I understand, there was a small chapel at the front, but that was gone. I have no memory of that. But the half church that became later was there. It began to grow, I guess I should say, as soon as the war was over and the men came back, and the Sunday school classrooms were overflowing, and I know they had some of the children's classes in the basement, in the boiler room, you know, everywhere they had a place for anything, and that's when they realized they needed more space.
But when I got there, and they had classes in the furnace room. And classes everywhere, steps. Everywhere we had a few steps, we had another class. But I was there not very long before I managed to convince them that we had to make some changes. And so we did. And we ended up building the extra building for Sunday school. And I was head of the committee for that. And I headed the committee for the next one we had. And my mother-in-law went to the church and she said, "You're foolish doing that. You just got everybody mad at you." But I really enjoyed doing anything I could at the church.
And you were involved with Sunday school for a long time?
Oh, yes. From the very beginning, I had gone to Albright and I had an English degree, but it was senior English. I caught over here, found out that the women who had had the kindergarten before had one reason or another left. So I started with the kindergarten, for which I had no knowledge with little children at all. So, and I was there about over 30 years before I changed what I was doing.
What was he like? Tell us what Reverend Reiner was like as a pastor, as a man. What was he like?
I think he was very conscientious, very concerned about his people. And he to me, he had a good ear for listening. And the people would come and tell him their problems, and at the end, usually he worked them out pretty well.
Reverend Reiner came to talk to me, and we talked about various things, and I said, "Well, what do you want from me?" "Well, I want you to join our church."
Oh! And you did.
And we did, yeah. And Reverend Reiner was a wonderful man. Well, the church was, to me, unique in a lot of ways. I loved Reverend Reiner. He was a top-notch man, and I felt fortunate to be with him and helping him in some ways. I was head of some of the departments for a while, and I really liked the church very much, and Reverend Reiner especially. We couldn't have had a better man than Reverend Reiner.
That's good.
We had a small garden in West Lawn that produced a lot, and then we went over to Colony Park, and he found out over there, at that time, there were very few trees or anything, and it was much colder winter, and a lot of the things froze. But he was getting older, too, by that time. He loved the garden.
Reverend Reiner was really one to do things by himself a lot. And he discovered that I was doing some things that he wasn't aware of. But he said, gee, I thought I was going to do that. You know.
So you were a good helper.
Yeah, I was his helper.
That's good.
Oh, my. But wonderful people. We were surrounded by wonderful people in that church. All dedicated people. We grew continually. And we had a wonderful church and a wonderful Sunday school.
Well, I had the kindergarten department for 30-some years. And when we got married and moved here, I had done my student teaching at Reading High. And I come here and have to go into the kindergarten with knowing nothing about little children. That was something. But I was there about 30-some years, and then I later we started another class for Sunday school of that was called Pairs and Spares. It's still functioning, isn't it? And then I was busy with that, getting that going and all. But then she decided to have a children's choir. And I love that because I could play for them. And in fact, when we had Bible school in the summertime, we couldn't go outside then. We had no place outside for them to recreate. So we'd take them into the chapel and have a sing-along. And we sang all kinds of things, and they loved it, you know. So that helped a lot, too.
So that was very special, working with the young children.
Enjoyed that always. I worked a lot with the altruistic class. Now, that's being specific, but they were the 30s and 40s age group women, and they were very active. And finally, we did all sorts of things, but we made fruitcakes for years.
And the fruitcakes, I guess they're big at Christmas time, right?
In the fall.
And we made about 800 pounds, you know. Each, we made 1 pound ones to make money for the church. The latter ones we did over there at the parsonage. Earlier we had done some here.
So there was, you've seen a lot of change with the church?
Oh my goodness, yes.
You've seen it grow.
One little building in the second portion of that first section of the ground. Then the front was put on, then this building, and we were here for all three of those stuff.
What makes this church so special?
I guess friendliness for one thing, and using people to do things I think would help. I'm thinking about way back when the women didn't work yet, but here at the church they had bake sales and soup sales and things to keep them working together and having some good purpose in mind.
I think at West Lawn we have a wonderful group of people, and I was glad I was an important part of it for a while. We had a wonderful time, and I really miss the Reverend Reiner. Oh my goodness, wonderful man. I was surrounded by wonderful people. I loved that church. I want to wish the church and everybody in it that they have a wonderful time for this reunion we're having.
Happy centennial for the West Lawn Church.
Well, you just saw a beautiful video segment of what's to come this year, the 100th year for West Lawn United Methodist Church. Let's move to the granddaughter of where the first congregation, the first service was held in 1912. Tell us about your family.
I don't know too much about my grandfather as he died in the early 1920s. However, it's very interesting to know that he owned most of the land on the side of the Penn Avenue where the church is up through to where the high school is. And he was a land developer and also did a lot of the concrete work. But it was very interesting to know that he gave his barn, which was located directly across from the church where the current parking lot is, near the Westland, this is Westland Motors, it's there. And he was a member of Haynes Church, and a lot of the history tells us that there was a lot of intermixing between Haynes Church and Westland Church at the time. And that he felt strongly enough, I guess, to give his barn that the church could worship there. And that later on, it shows that my grandmother, after his death, and my father and his siblings also continued to worship there, when some of them later were confirmed at Westlawn Church also before they moved to other areas. When I was looking for another church, another United Methodist Church in the area, I was led to Westlawn due to the fact that the family history, as well as I was really impressed with all the outreach of Westlawn into the community, not just into the local community where they were located, but into the city and beyond the area.
Wonderful. Well, it's safe to assume then your family is the longest running family of the 100 year of the church. Mm-hmm. And you're still active, and we thank you for that, especially your grandparents in helping it start the location of the first congregation. Let's talk about some of the memorabilia that we have with the rock, the collection plate. Bev and Jim, please tell us what you brought in tonight.
Okay, Tom. First of all, I wanted to say our church was founded on Ascension Day, May 16, 1912. A year later, in 1913, the Westlawn Chapel was built, often referred to as the Friendly Church. Now, here's a picture of our Friendly Church right there in front of me. Now, right here, this is a stone from the chapel that one of our members of the church, Annetta Hostetter, retrieved when the building was being raised. And along with this stone right here was a collection plate that she also was able to retrieve.
Wonderful. And these are on display throughout the year and many years to come at Westlawn United Methodist Church, as they are in cases throughout the campus of the community church. Ben.
Well, then in 1926, a larger brick building was built on the site of the church, the chapel. And this building, I have a photo of this building as it existed back in 1927. That's how our church looked. And at that time, we had a service under the direction of Dr. Paul Wirt. And he was the pastor then, and we had a dedication service. And also from that time period, we have a confirmation class picture that dates back to 1937. And this is Pastor Brown was serving us then. And this, I think, is just beautiful. Eva Adams, one of our former members, sent this to me. It's a cradle roll certificate that was hers when she was young, and it's just so ornate and very beautiful. And this dates back to 1932. Then in the, I guess it was the mid 30s and the late and the into the 40s, why our church kind of suffered a decline, as Betty was saying, the war was on, and there weren't, the attendance had gone down greatly. And that's whenever Raleigh and Betty Reiner came on the scene, and they were there for the 40 years, and our church was revived and grew a great deal during that time. We also expanded our church at that time, and we had we expanded it in 1957. And in 1957, after we laid the cornerstone and expanded our church, then during that time also the education building was built. And this is a photo of the education building. And that this education building has been dedicated to as the Raleigh and Betty Reiner Education Center. There's so much more to the history of our church, and you saw the present day photo of our church earlier. And I just want to say, from our standpoint, that we've been so blessed over these past 100 years.
Indeed we have. Mike, can you give us a wrap on before we go to closure?
I can. We're celebrating 100 years of West Lawn United Methodist Church, and we have a dynamic, growing church. We have a lot of ministries going around the block and around the world. We have a lot of friendly people. We love the Lord, and we'd love to have you come and worship God with us sometime and join us for our centennial West Lawn United Methodist Church. Glory to God.
Absolutely. Invite, embrace, empower is truly the magic of what's really there at the cornerstone at Woodside Avenue and Penn Avenue. Been there 100 years and many more to come. So we invite you to come out to this great community church, become a member, become active. See what's available for you that you can benefit from. And more importantly, help us celebrate 100 years of God's grace. I'm Tom Frank for the Victory Programming, thanking you all for staying tuned in here to BCTV. Be informed, be involved.